Hello, good morning, and welcome to another edition of Command Your Morning. I am Minister Melvin Nero, and I would like to take this time to bring greetings on behalf of our Bishop, Bishop Robinson Chester Allen, and his wife, Pastor Gloria Allen. And to you, our viewers, I would like to say a special good morning to you and thank you for having us. And I would like to spend a special good morning to my beautiful wife this morning, who always support and encourage me. So I would like to just send a special morning to her this morning. Amen. So as we are here again this morning to encourage ourselves in the Word of God and to come before God this morning into His presence with prayer and worship and to spend time in the scriptures this morning. We are so thankful for life, that God had given us strength, that we can see a new day, and next time to make it right before Him. As we go into our morning session, I would like us to look at the life of Peter, the Apostle Peter, this morning, because I believe there is so much we can learn from him. One, he was chosen by Jesus. We see this in the book of John, chapter 1, and verse 41 to 42, which read, "He first findeth his own brother Simon, and said unto him, We have found the Messiah, which is, being interpreted, the Christ. And he brought him to Jesus, and Jesus beheld him. He said, Thou art Simon, the son of Jonah. Thou shalt be called Cephas, which is by interpretation a stone." And two, he was given a revelation from God about the Christ. We will find that in the book of Matthew, chapter 16, verse 13 to 17, which says, "When Jesus came into the coast of Caesarea Philippi, he asked his disciples, saying, Who do men say that I, the Son of Man, am? And they said, Some say that thou art John the Baptist, some Elias, and others Jeremiah, or one of the prophets. He said unto him, But whom say ye that I am? And Simon Peter answered and said, Thou art the Christ, the Son of the living God. And Jesus answered and said unto him, Blessed art thou, Simon Bar-Jonah, for flesh and blood had not revealed it unto thee, but my Father which is in heaven." So with this basic knowledge, we would like to go into our main scripture this morning. For having this basic knowledge of the person of Peter, just summarizing two passages of scripture we just read, we would like to go to Luke chapter 22, verse 31 to 34, to get the message and where we are coming from this morning. Because I believe it is so important that the life that the Bible shows us that Peter once lived, it can help us in our belief today and also our walk with Christ. So we're looking at Luke chapter 22 and verse 31 to 34, which says, "And the Lord said, Simon, Simon, behold, Satan had desire to have you, that he may sift you as wheat. But I have prayed for thee, that thy faith fail not. And thou, And when thou art converted, strengthen thy brethren. And he said unto him, Lord, I am ready to go with thee, both into prison and to death. And he said unto him, I tell thee, Peter, the cock shall not crow this day before thou shalt thrice deny that thou knowest me. So, the question is, can someone be a follower of Jesus Christ and still not be converted? I'm going to repeat the question. The question is, can someone be a follower of Jesus Christ and still not be converted? For the word of God says, many are called, chosen are few. And on the last day, the Bible says that many shall come saying, Lord, Lord, we have prophesied in thy name. We have healed in thy name. We have worked miracles in thy name. And Jesus will say, depart from me, workers of iniquity, I knew you not. So the question still remains, can someone be a follower of Jesus Christ and still not be converted? We want to look this morning at the word converted and what does it mean? The word converted means to change from or to change or turn into another substance or form. I'm going to repeat it. The word converted means to change or turn into another substance or form. As we look at 2 Corinthians chapter 5 and verse 17, which read, therefore, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. Old things are passed away, and behold, all things are become new. So when we look at the whole aspect of it, of the conversion, or to be converted, it's one substance moving, it's moving from one place to another place. As the scripture shows us, from the old man to the new man, who is in Christ Jesus. So, the question still remains. Can someone be a follower of Jesus Christ and still not be converted? Many of us are living that life today whereby we deny Christ by the life we live. Many of us, we deny Christ by simply the life we are living. It is not pleasing to God. And we call ourselves believers, and our life cannot show account day by the life we live. So simply by our lifestyle, we also can deny Christ. Many of us are like Peter, who will say, Lord, I am ready to go to prison for you and to die for you. But when that time of testing comes, my question is, will you deny Christ? The question still remains. Can someone be a follower of Jesus Christ and still not be converted? Hallelujah. But the Lord had prayed for Peter that his faith fail not. And when he be converted, strengthen thy brethren. But we preach Christ crucified. And many of us have the thought, but have not yet been converted. So this morning, we want to spend time in prayer this morning. We want to spend time that those of us who are converted, as the Lord command Peter, that when thou be converted, strengthen thy brethren. So we want to spend this time this morning that those who are called of him and those who believe in him, that there is a difference. We must come to that place of being converted as we can go forth, that our light so shine before men that they may see our good works and glorify our Father which is in heaven. So we want to spend that time this morning, this very time, strengthening the brethren and giving hope to those who are hopeless, those who have not yet come to that place in Christ Jesus, those who have not yet understand what it is to be saved and what it means to be saved. Our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ came and bare our sin on the cross, that we will have life and have it more abundantly. So this morning, we want to strengthen the brethren this morning. We want to come from that place of just being a follower and be converted. So, oh God and Heavenly Father, we thank you this morning. Father God, we exalt your name this morning, oh God. Father God, we know that you are God and all by yourself. Lord, there is none can compare unto you, oh Father. Lord, we exalt your holy name, oh God. Father, we lift you up this morning. As I bring the brethren before you this morning, oh God. Those who, oh Lord, who are called by you, oh God. Those, oh God, who have come to that place to serve you, oh God. Lord, I pray that they be strengthened, oh God, and come to that place of truly knowing you and move from that place, oh God, of just being called, but be converted, oh God, that when the time of trial come, oh Father, that they will really be ready to go to prison, oh God, even unto death, oh Father. Father, we strengthen them this morning, oh God. Father, even myself, oh God, every one of us this morning, oh God, that we find that place in you, oh God, that we are willing to go the distance, oh God. In your word, you say, if any man desire to come after me, first he must deny himself and take up his cross. So this morning, oh God, Father, we pray that every believer and everyone who is called by your name, oh God, come to that place and bear the cross this morning. Take the challenge this morning, oh God, because the time we are living in, our faith will be tested. Not only in the simple way of life, but even unto death. Because as we see it today, oh God, all over the world, Christians are being persecuted every day for your name's sake, oh God. But you say, oh Lord, rejoice and be exceedingly glad, for great is our reward in heaven. So, oh Father, as we encourage our brethren this morning, oh God, we pray that they find strength in you this morning, Lord, that we will come to that full understanding and encourage each other, oh God, even those who are babes in Christ. You say that they will be fed by milk. Lord, we pray, oh God, that they will be fed properly, oh God, that their faith will grow and increase, that they will move from faith to faith, from glory to glory, oh God, to withstand the time that we are living in, Father, because the time is getting even more cruel. We see it every day, oh God. So, Father, I call upon you this morning, oh Lord, that your spirit be with us this morning, oh God. Strengthen us as believers, oh God. As we pray for each other this morning, oh God. Father, I lift up the ministries this morning, oh God. I lift up the pastors this morning, oh God. That they will feed the sheep, oh God. Word of encouragement. Word that strengthen the faith, oh God. So when that time of testing comes, Father, they will not deny you and your only begotten Son, Father. Because we know in him there is life and life everlasting. So we want to strengthen the brethren this morning as we pray for the leaders this morning, oh God. Give them insight and foresight this morning, oh God, that they will preach Christ and him crucified. That within this message, we know we have life. We have life. Because the word of God says, those who are crucified with him will not live by him because he lived and reigned forevermore. So, oh God and Heavenly Father, we pray that this gospel be preached every day, oh God, and every time, oh God, to strengthen the believers, Father, that our faith faileth not, oh God. So, Father, we thank you this morning as we lift up the brethren this morning, oh God. As we lift up every believer this morning, oh God. Father, we pray that their step are ordered, oh God, by you this morning, oh God. That the word they speak, oh God, will be oracles of the word of God this morning. That they will speak life and give life to those who, oh God, who need, oh God. Who have not yet come to that place, oh God, that they the self who have heard them speak, oh God, and walk according to your way, oh God, that their life will draw men unto you, Father, that they will be converted as well, oh God. Father, we lift you up this morning, and we know, God, that you are more than able. We know, oh God, that you can do, oh God, the abundance and above, oh God. But Father, we pray this morning. We pray this morning, oh God, that we do not go to the left nor to the right of thy word. Because the time is coming, Lord, and it is already here. Lord, we see it every day. We hear it in the news every day. Christians are being murdered for you, oh Lord, for your name's sake. And we are here this morning. We just want to strengthen the brethren in prayer this morning. Give them encouragement because that time is coming. It is coming, brethren. It is coming. And we need to build our faith. We need to build our faith that our faith fail not because it's a time of testing. It is a time of testing where we will know where we stand in the Lord. If we are just followers or we are in Christ. So, oh God and Heavenly Father, we make this appeal to the believers and non-believers also that they be converted and come and find life more abundant and life that leads to eternity. Dear God and Heavenly Father, I pray for them all ministries this morning. I pray that this gospel be preached. Strengthen the brethren. Strengthen the brethren. Strengthen the brethren. Our faith needs to be built. Our faith needs to come to that place that we don't deny Christ. We don't deny this gospel. Even in our simple everyday life, our steps are ordered by God. So, brethren, sisters, each and every one of us, let us come to that place. Let us come to that place and strengthen the brethren. I am so moved this morning to speak on this particular topic this morning, that our faith faileth not, and that we come to that true place of being converted. To be converted, to change from that old man into that new man whose life is no longer of his own but belongs to Christ because he had paid the ransom. So we no longer live on our behalf but Christ. And he laid down his life for our sins that we might have life. So this morning, brethren, let us not grow weak in our faith. Let us not take every day simple. Because as simple as it looks, we can't deny Christ. We can't deny Christ. And not knowing. Because we look at life too simple. When life is to really worship God. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. And we need to get back to that place in the glory of God. Because it's for that same purpose we were created. Every man was created in the likeness and the image of God. That we may dwell with him in eternity. So brethren, I am making an appeal this morning. I see it so fit as a scripture making known to us that our faith faileth not. And let us truly be converted in our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. And to those who are not yet come to that place of knowing the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we give you this opportunity right now in the name of Jesus. We make this opportunity known to you this morning that you can come to this place in Christ Jesus and find everlasting life. Because the time will come where each and every one of us will find life, but where? Some unto the resurrection, unto eternal life, which is in heaven, and some unto condemnation, which is in the lake of fire. Which one do you choose this morning? Which one do you choose this morning? But through God, he had make it possible this morning that you can find life and have it more abundantly with him. In his word, he said he had gone to prepare a place for us. And that place is for the believers, those who come to that place, those who understand his redemption plan and the salvation through Jesus Christ. We give this opportunity this morning for those who are not yet saved, not yet being converted, that you can come to this place in Christ and accept him as your Lord and Savior, that you will find peace in yourself, that thy faith faileth not in the time of testing, that you stand firm upon the word of God and your faith, that we fail not. So this morning, if you have come to that place, we want to pray for you this morning. Father, we lift up those, oh God, who have heard this message this morning and desire to come to that place, oh God, of being converted, and those who have not yet saved have made up their mind, oh God, to follow you and to be converted, oh God. Father, we lift them up before you this morning, oh Father. We thank you for them, oh God. He said, no man can come unto you unless the Father bring them, oh God. So, oh God and Heavenly Father, we thank you this morning, oh God, for them, for these life this morning, oh God, who have come to that place. Father, we thank you, oh God, for the sacrifice you have made, oh God, that it is possible that they will find life and shall have life, oh God. So, oh God and Heavenly Father, we thank you for them this morning. If you want to come to that place and you accept Jesus Christ, simply confess, believe with thy heart and confess with thy mouth. Say, Lord, that I am a sinner and I've come to realize, oh God, that I was lost, but now I'm found through Jesus Christ. And I repent of my sin this day. I give my life to you, O God, for the remission of sin. And O God and Heavenly Father, thank you for saving me. Thank you, O God, that your love never fails and your mercies are forever. May believe in your heart and confess with your mouth The Bible says those who believe and confess are saved. All you need to do now is find a Bible-based believing church who's based upon the doctrine of Jesus Christ and preach this very same gospel of repentance and death, burial, and resurrection of our Lord. You can fellowship with such. But if you do not have any church to attend to, I invite you at our Sunday morning worship, 11 o'clock, at the Healing Tabernacle Ministries International, which is located at Lambo Village, Nursery School Street. And we are always happy to welcome you into our service. So as the Lord permit and give us day by day, let us not forget what the Word of God says. Let us not just be a hearer, but also a doer of the Word. And let us encourage each other day by day, time by time. Lift up each other in prayer. Strengthen thy brethren. Strengthen thy brethren. That our faith faileth not. And let us walk in obedience according to the word of God. Let us dedicate our time. Find time in prayer. Find time for worship. And don't be caught up in the everyday life. Because heaven and earth will pass away. But thy word will never. So let us spend time in the word. Let us spend time in prayer. That our faith faileth not. As I will repeat, the time is coming. The time is coming that our faith will be tested. It will be tested. Will we deny Christ? So the question still remains. Can someone be a follower of Jesus Christ and be not yet converted? Search your heart this morning as I search mine, because we don't want our faith to fail. So I thank you for having us this morning. And next time, as we come, we spend look at another verse of scripture which I would like us to share in, that our faith faileth not. Amen.